Everyone, welcome back. This is Naveen from UiRents. So in this video, let's start with add employee button events. So here, so what we have done is just made a get request. Yeah, let me click on add employee. We got a model and let's add little animation for the model. Actually not required. Even you can add for the content. I'll add animated. Slide in left. Okay, so if you add an animation, let's check now. Yes, looks good. Fine. So now when you fill in the details and when you click on add employee, I need to create a new employee using Ajax post request. So when you click on this button or else when a form submits, so we have a form here, add employee form. Let's make the form now, copy this. So after all this, let's make add employee form. Okay, so let's add employee form is equal to documents dot query selector of hash add employee form. Now so this form we need to apply the submit event because we are submitting the form now. So add employee form dot add event listener of submit comma one function. Okay, so when a form submits, you get the event. I don't want the page to refresh. I don't want automatic form submission. To prevent the automatic form submission, you can do e dot prevent default. Okay, fine. And then this is to stop auto form submits, and then when I click on this button, see, suppose I enter some data, okay, at gmail.com. When I fill in some data, when I click on add employee, the employee model has not been closed. I want to close the employee model as soon as you click on this button, so that I want to do it programmatically. So that's very simple. You write a small single line of jQuery code, because that's a bootstrap is made in jQuery. So you have to write a jQuery code, one single line. How to do is, yeah, let me get this model. Here I write dollar, this is jQuery selector, hash the model dot, there's a function called model here. You just call a hide. So this is to close the model. Okay, so whenever form submits successfully, you're gonna close the model. Okay, so let's check now. When I click on this, I fill in some details and something, it closed the model. Okay, but we need to fetch the form data. To fetch form data, let's make like this. Let's take employee is equal to, so we need to have a fields. So first name, so first name is gonna be document dot, so first name is gonna be this form field data. So how to make that form field data is, we have ID, right? Add first name is the ID. So document dot query selector, query selector of hash add first name dot value comma, so let's make last name. So this is gonna be add last name dot value, and email, this is gonna be add email dot value, and gender. So gender is add gender dot value, and finally IP address is gonna be add IP minus address. So you should be very careful with these IDs. Okay, so I given a proper IDs, I think so. Yep, done. So we got address. Okay, so we got a form data, and we also create dynamic object. So this object we're going to send to the Ajax post request to store. So for that we need to have a URL. Let's URL is equal to post request URL. So let's make a backtick. So post request is URL is same as this one, get abs/employees. So dollar server URL slash employees. Okay, that's a URL is ready. Data is ready. Let's call. So let HTTP is equal to new brain HTTP. Now HTTP dot post. Here first thing is URL and my employee object and one callback. So here you will get the data as a response. Okay, so here I'll just make a console dot log of data just for cross check. And also see here, so whenever you fill in the form data, it is created server side, but I want to see that on the page. So let's call fetch users again. So fetch all employees one more time. So what happens, as soon as it is pushed to the server, it also fetch it and display on a screen. So I think it's done. So let's check now. Go back. You just also observe page is not gonna refresh. Okay, so add employee, you got this. So let's make first name Rajan Jain. So rajan@gmail.com mail. So 127.0.0.1 add employee. So page should not refresh. Yes, I got a new record called Rajan. Okay, and you can also check the console window to see you got an object message post request is success, and we also have a data here. Okay, so looks good. And when I click on add employee again, yeah, here is a problem. When I click on add employee again, but data is still there, I don't want this, I want to make it empty. So to want to make it empty, I'll do one thing, I call some other function. So clear form fields. Okay, function, let me copy this. Let's create a function. Let's clear form fields is equal to a function. So what I do is I just clear all the form fields values. You can do it in a shortcut. I'll just fetch these data. I'll paste it. I don't need to keep this, not required. Okay, so value is equal to empty. I need this. So copy, paste. This is empty, this is empty, this is also empty. So I'm just making manually all the fields to be in an empty. So let's check let me test the application one more time. So back here, Rajan is there. Let's make here, let's make my name Naveen Sagam, naveen@gmail.com, and gender male, some IP address 98.something.something.something. Okay. Actually dot is missing. Yeah, so add, see my name is added with some other ID, looks good. But when I click on add employee again, yes, you have a empty fields so that you can enter new person's data, and it won't let you submit empty because we made a required attribute. Fine, so we can able to create a new employee with Ajax. Now let's make an update. What is update is when I click on update button, it has to pop up a model with all the fields on the page. And when I click on delete, let me delete the page. So let's start with the delete request, and update will start with in the last. So to perform this is quite difficult. I just tell you, let's make an event on the entire table body. Okay, so what I do is see table body. Okay, so I have copy. So what I'm doing, click events on entire table body. Okay, so let's table body is equal to document dot query selector of hash table body and table body dot add event listener of click comma one function. Okay, so now what I'm doing is you get the event here. I just say let's target element is equal to event dot target. Okay, let's make a console dot log of target element. So what it does is in the entire table body, whatever the element you click, so that HTML element is gonna print it on a console. So that based on this, I gonna verify are we click on update button or delete button exactly. Okay, so to resolve these two, I made this e.target. So this will give you this particular employee on the entire table body which you have clicked. So let's check now. Inspect console. See here. When I click on ID, what happened? You get TD with ID. So when I click on update, you got a button. Update. When I click on delete, you got a button delete. Yes, exactly. I need this one. So how can you differentiate its update button or delete button? You can differentiate based on its class name. See, we have applied some extra class called update and delete. So whenever the target element is having a class called update, so we know that we click on update. If the class is having delete, then I can say that yes, we click on a delete button. So how can I do that? Check is if target element dot, there's something called class list dot contains delete. So if the target element's class, the number of classes are there, right? In that, if it is contains delete as a class, so I can say that you clicked delete button. Okay, fine. And I'll make another if it contains update. Because why I'm writing this is, see, when I'm constructing, I have given wantedly update and delete, right? So I'm just taking that class only here. So if it is contains update, you click on a update button. So let's check now this thing back here. If I click on this thing, if I click on any other link, nothing is coming in a console because nothing is matched with our if condition. So when I click on update, yes, you click on update button. When I click on delete, you click on delete button. Now delete, update, delete, update. Okay, works perfect. Fine. Now thing is, whenever I click on this delete, yes, I know that I click on delete button, but my thing is, when I click on delete, I want to delete exactly this particular row. But to delete this row, we need to fetch the ID. It means when I click on delete, I need to have this ID. When I click on this delete, I need to have this ID. So let's see how to get this particular ID. Is see here. Yeah, see, this is delete button, right? So this delete button parent element is TD. Its parent element is TR. So let's do that. What I'm doing is let the element is equal to, so target element dot parent element dot parent element. So if I do two times parent element, see here. Button parent element is TD and its parent is TR. Let's check now. If you put only one, what happens? Now see, I click on delete. I think I have not done the console log. Console.log of the elements. Now check delete. You get the TD, but I want its parents. So dot parent elements. Now check. Click on delete. I got TR. So the entire TR I got. So this delete specific TR I got. But in this I just need only this ID. So how to get this ID? So for this TR, first child's inner text. Okay, this is gonna be the first child's inner text. So dot first element child dot inner HTML. Okay, so this is gonna be the selected ID. Okay, it's not gonna be the element, it's actually a ID. Okay, so this like this you have to parse the entire HTML tags. Now check. When I click on delete, yes, exactly ABCDEF I got. So when I click on Naveen, yes, exactly that ID has come. So now based on this ID, if you have an ID, you can make an Ajax delete request to delete that, right? So let's do that now. So we fetch the ID, right? So now as soon as you get the ID, so let's make a URL. Let URL is equal to, I need to have, see, for delete, what is a URL? Server URL employee slash the ID what you want to delete, that one. So let's make server URL slash employees slash the ID. So let's make dynamic selected ID, and then you have to delete. Delete means let HTTP is equal to new brain HTTP. So now HTTP dot delete, you need to provide the URL and the callback. So this callback is having data. Let's make a console log of data. And as soon as it is deleted, I just call a function called fetch employees to fetch display back the employees records. Okay, so this is actually a delete request. So click on delete button, and this logic is actually, we have not done the update, we'll make it. This is make update button. So when you click on delete button, make Ajax call to delete. Let's check now. So I just close it. See, I have this one. So when I click on John Wilson, I click on delete. See, it's gone, deleted. Laura Wilson, deleted. My name, deleted. So it is able to delete the employee record, right? So one last thing is, and slight complex thing is, update. What update has to do is, when I click on this update button, it has to pop up a model with this data. So let's see how to make an update operation in the next video. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll meet next video. Thank you.